To make this example easier to follow, let me show the default planes in this assembly. To add mates, you simply click on the paperclip icon here in the assembly toolbar, or activate mates from the Insert drop-down menu. Mates are defined here in the Property Manager. If I hold my cursor over this window for just a second, you can see that SOLIDWORKS wants me to select entities to mate. I'll pick the front plane of the assembly, and you can see it appears in the selection window. And I'll select this face of the part. Immediately, SOLIDWORKS positions the part to be coincident with the front plane. And this toolbar, called the Mate Pop-Up Toolbar, appears near the selected entities. At this point, I have the option to change the type of mate, either on this toolbar or in the Property Manager. Both will have the same result. I can keep the coincident mate or switch to Parallel or Perpendicular. I can also establish a distance or an angle between the face and plane I selected. In this case, I'll accept coincident, which means I want this face to be located directly on the front plane of the assembly. Notice there are two possible solutions here. I can have the part on either side of the front plane and still satisfy the coincident mate. To control which side the part will end up on, I can use the aligned and anti-aligned options here. In the Mate pop-up toolbar, this function corresponds with this icon here. Don't worry about the exact definitions of aligned and anti-aligned. Just remember that they're opposites. If one doesn't work, try the other. Once the preview shows the result you like, click on the green check and the mate is established. Remember earlier I was able to drag this part around and rotate it without restrictions? By adding the coincident mate, I've locked down some of these freedoms, but not all. By moving the part, you can see that I'm still able to move the part. However, because of the coincident mate, the movement is limited. This is the basic approach to assemblies. Bring in a part that is completely free to move in space. Then add mates to restrict this movement. Let's lock this part down even further by adding more mates. This time, I'll pick the top plane in this face. I'll use a coincident mate again. The next mate will be between the right plane and this face here. Once again, I'll be using a coincident mate. Since I'm done with mates at this point, all I have to do is click the X to turn off the tool. If I try to move the part, I'll get a message indicating that the part is fully defined. You can see that the feature tree no longer shows the minus sign next to the part. Also in the feature tree, you see that I've got a plus sign next to mates. This is where the mates I've created are stored. By expanding this, you can see the three coincident mates I've created, along with the entities that were used with each mate. As I move my cursor over the mates, you can also see the mated entities highlight in the graphics area. As with most things that are listed in the Feature Manager tree, I can make changes to mates by clicking on them and selecting Edit Feature. Here I can change the entities that are used, even change the type of mate if necessary.